Hey everyone, Justisaur Stone here. I thought that instead of doing the typical 2015 end of the year thing where we look back at everything that was released this year and what's the best and what's the worst, I thought instead I would look forward to seeing all the new stuff that's being released in terms of light novels that we know about so far in the year 2016. So, we start off in January with the release of Volume 1 of Seraph of the End. Now, this is much like what they did with Attack on Titan. This is actually a prequel to the manga series and slash anime adaptation. So, this one looks at the main character of that series just before the whole vampire apocalypse took place. So this is a prequel series to the manga. I believe there's two or three volumes in it. So the first one comes out January 26th is the release date that has been slated for it. On February 23rd, we get a one-shot, which is The Boy and the Beast, which is the light novel adaptation of the anime. And it's about a young boy who pretty much literally falls through the cracks in the city of Tokyo and finds himself in this land of beasts with, walking, talking animals, and he befriends this great big bear who carries a sword. And they find out that their friendship actually might have the fate of both their worlds resting on its shoulders. On March 8th, we get Volume 1 of Legend of Galactic Heroes. Now, this is actually an older series. There was an anime done many years ago. It's a very, very sort of popular and pretty seminal sci-fi book series in Japan, and so we're finally getting a official translation here in North America. And basically what it does is there's two sort of warring factions in this galactic empire, and it follows a character in each of those factions as they sort of rise through the ranks and come into conflict with one another. In April, we get two releases. There is The Irregular at Magic High School, which there was just an anime adaptation done of this series, I believe, just this past year. And it focuses on a world where magic has been made possible through the power of science. And it focuses on a brother and sister who are attending one of Japan's most prestigious magic schools. And the thing is that the sister is considered incredibly gifted and put at the sort of top rank when she enters into the school, whereas her brother kind of ends up with all the misfits and the sort of lesser powered. But while there's a lot more to his story we discover and a lot more to his abilities than what's initially led on. And it's just about sort of the adventures that happens with the school and, you know, getting involved in geopolitics. And there's a pretty wide breadth of storylines, at least there certainly was in the anime. We'll see whether the light novel does the same. Also in April, we have Bakano, which is also written by the author who did Durarara, which we've already had two volumes released at this point. This one takes place in New York City in the 1920s and sounds like it's very similar to Durarara, which is, it focuses almost on this sort of seedy, underbelly, criminal element of New York, but yet also has some supernatural elements to it as well. In May, on May 24th, we get Volume 1 of Overlord. Now, this is another one of those series where we have a person from our modern world being trapped in a video game world. The big difference here, though, is that instead of him becoming a hero, or instead of him trying to find his way out, he decides that since he's there, he is going to become the tyrant and conqueror of all things. And so we actually get the anti-hero in this particular scenario. So that changes the things up a little bit, and I'm looking forward to seeing how that one turns out. In June, we get two new releases. That's June 21st. Both of them come out. There is My Teen Romantic Snafu, which is sort of about a antisocial loner who finds himself being forced into a service club, which I guess is, the idea is that they help people with their problems. And it's just generally how I guess he comes out of his shell and kind of the hijinks that ensue. It sounds like a slice of life type story. I'm not too familiar with it. I know there is an anime, but I haven't checked it out yet. The other one that's released that month is Psycom, which is about a boy who is framed for a crime and ends up in sort of a juvenile detention type center with a whole bunch of beautiful girls who also happen to be murderers. And so I guess, again, it's what happens when all of that comes together. Finally, in 2016, there are three more titles that have been announced, but we don't have actual release dates yet. So first of all is Asterisk War, which there was just an anime finished of, I guess, the first couple of volumes of that, an adaptation. It's about a school which teaches kids to battle, I guess. I'm supposing there's magic involved. Again, I've stayed away from the anime because I knew that the light novels were coming and I didn't want to spoil any of it for myself. But basically it sounds that it's sort of like a battle competition between different schools and these kids are learning to basically battle for sport. Another one that's coming out is called ReZero, and it, again, is a modern person falling into a fantasy world. The interesting aspect here, though, is that what he ends up discovering is that his ability is that when he is killed, he goes back in time. And so the whole thing is that he has absolutely no other powers other than to die and to try and fix whatever happened between the point that he revived and the point that he died. Finally, we have the spin-off of Is It Wrong to Try to Pick Up Girls in a Dungeon? It is Sword Oratoria. This one focuses on Eyes Wallenstein, which is the object of Belle's affection in Is It Wrong to Try to Pick Up Girls? And it sounds like that's this series sort of follows her when she was away from the main action of the main series. So it sort of intersperses and connects to that series. So it is a spin-off, and it seems like it's taking place basically in that sort of same time frame that the main series does. So again, there's a whole bunch of really exciting brand new light novels that are going to be coming out, and these are just the ones that have been announced so far. We may get other announcements early in the year and get later in the year releases. I do believe that like Asterisk War and stuff is probably going to be a late summer, early fall. That's probably when we'll get those. Maybe we'll get some new ones come October, November, but I'm imagining those won't be announced until in the early year. And of course, on top of all of that, we have a lot of amazing ongoing series, many of which I am reading and reviewing on this channel. So we have tons to look forward to in 2016, aside from the fact that I really don't know how I'm going to keep up with all of it. So that's the video, guys. I hope that you found something here that you're excited about and that you're looking forward to. Do some more research into these titles if just my little blurb made you sound interested in it. I hope you'll join me in 2016 and see what all of my thoughts are on these new books as well as the new volumes in the existing series that I've been reading. So click on subscribe, give the video a like if you enjoyed it. Thanks very much for watching. I'll see you next time. Until then, bye-bye for now.